So let's take a look at the tail of the tape for this one. Politylo from Poland, making his fight game out in Dublin, Ireland. Tonight we'll face Nathan Kelly from the Republic of Ireland. Both men young. Both men nearly identical in height. Perfect on the scales yesterday, right at the weight limit of the bantamweight division. Edge in winning ways for Pawel, but Nathan Kelly, the edge and amateur experience. Both guys talented and looking to make an impression in their BAMMA career. Here's Buddy Johnson to get this one underway at 135.
Live from the 3 Arena in Dublin, Ireland, this is BAMMA 35. We are set for 3 5-minute rounds of action in the bantamweight division. Now first, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 5'7" tall and weighing officially at 134.1 pounds. He has 2 defeats to his credit and represents Kyuso MMA from Finglas, Dublin. Make some noise for Nathan Kelly. And his opponent in the red corner, standing 5'6½" tall. He has a professional record of a single win and a single defeat. Representing Phantom MMA, the Polish-born from Dublin, Ireland. Make some noise for Pawel Politylo. When the action begins, your referee in charge is Mr. Declan Larkin.
So one of the best in the business, Declan Larkin in charge for this one. Both men young, hungry, and eager to make that next big step in BAMMA. Nathan Kelly in the blue corner. Pawel Politylo in the red.
Neither of these guys are salad dodgers, Chris, so I would imagine that it's going to be a frenetic pace with this fight. Nathan, the more athletic of the two, but Pawel is that stocky, powerful build, so if he lands, I'd imagine it's going to be an early night.
I saw Politylo actually in the 3 Arena previously last fall take a very tough decision loss to Anton Rocic, one of the top guys in Europe at 135 pounds. So you know he can wrestle, you know he can grapple. We love seeing that type of athleticism in this lighter weight division at 135 pounds.
Absolutely. The tough fight stands you. That's where you find out where the grit is, you know, that you can, no matter, even when the going gets tough, that you can dig deep and you can really pull it out of fire. So that experience will stand to him here.
So some early exchanges here, nothing too convincing. Good feeling out process. Pawel showing that takedown. That's the thing about this weight division though, the way that they change angles, the way that they mix up their takedowns. Politylo actually shooting, breaking, looking for that kick to the body on the exit, Rich.
Yeah, caught him on a nice body shot there as Nate circled around the cage. So Nate needs to watch out for that. He's got to get timed once off that, so. He wants to watch for those big shots that are coming as he circles around that cage.
Politylo, tons of forward pressure.
Yeah, he's headhunting. He's looking for the big shot here. Nate needs to be careful of that. Nate's hands are low, so Pavel's looking to time him with those big, big overhand rights. Missed him with an overhand right elbow there that would have done serious damage if he had connected.
But it says a whole lot about Nathan. You know, he's 7-2 as an amateur. He's got TKOs. He's got chokes. 3-year career from 2014 to 2017. This is not his first rodeo. No. He's got that base.
No, well, you can see how relaxed he is there. He's after getting taken down there, and you can see straight away how relaxed he is. Technical stand up there, straight back in. He's not phased. Oh!
Huge right hand lands there. Pawel surging forward. Just as we saw Nathan starting to work some magic. An early scare here.
Yeah, he's after keeping his composure there, and he's after getting the waist lock and then back into a takedown, so he's after keeping his composure. So you can see where that experience doesn't get phased when he gets a big overhand right.
Body lock takedown there. Trying to expose the back. Politylo turning in.
Nathan will be clearing the head here as well, so you know this is all good stuff from Nathan.
We talked about it. He hasn't had a win in the professional ranks, but this guy knows how to compete in MMA, and that really speaks volumes. When you're so young, you've been in these positions, you've had multiple training camps. He's a competitor, and right now he's showing it.
Absolutely. Look, you can see the composure that he has in there. He got hit with a big shot, didn't get phased, straight away went to the right thing, got the waist lock, engaged in the clinch, and now he's in the ascendancy. But as I say that, Pawel Politylo is going for a Kimura there.
Yeah, Politylo was actually using that figure four counter. That's a good trick when someone's trying to take your back. He's got that figure four control, but Rich, can he work the position?
It's really interesting to see. Nathan's doing all the right things here now. But if I was Nathan, I'd back over. That's exactly what he's doing.
So back to the upright here. Pawel shooting for the single. Getting the double, gets the pickup. Can he get the slam?
You can see the power there from Pawel. You can see he didn't really commit to the takedown. As soon as he locked those hands together, it was only one way it was going to go. Nathan went up and he went down. Oh, good elbows from Nathan.
Nice elbows from the back. Nathan Kelly staying active here. Open guard. Hurtful elbows here. Up go the legs. High guard. Can he convert to the triangle or the armbar here, Richard?
It looks like it, but Pawel want to be careful of those elbows. And then you get an eyebrow open there, and that would definitely get stuck. He's going for the slam.
Nice grip strength there. Kelly got picked up, but he held on. And really, those leg curls that he was doing with his guard there, Richard, showed a lot of focus and calmness under pressure.
Absolutely, and he's just picking Pawel apart with these elbows. Pawel's getting into his position, putting his head in range of Nathan's elbows, a comfortable position, and Nathan's just picking him apart. There's going to be cuts here. There's going to be cuts open to Pavel's eyes if he continues to do this.
And Richard, there's a lot to be said. You know, somebody might look at MMA and see someone on their back and think they're losing the fight, but in this position, Kelly's being active. He's avoiding the worst of any short punches from the top position from Pawel, and he's obviously attacking with those elbows.
Absolutely. I'm very familiar with this. My own coach is probably the dirtiest player in the game, Dave Roach. He's an absolute advocate of working off your back and being able to open those elbows. And well done from Nathan Kelly. Back up. And good sprawl from Pawel.
And Kelly's shooting for a takedown. Short uppercut there from Pawel Politylo. Both men showing the signs of battle here, Richard.
Yeah, it looks like both of them are opened up. I'm not sure how serious they are, but those elbows look to have taken an effect on Pawel. And again.
Nice takedown there. 10-second clapper goes. Not much time in the round here. Politywo and Kelly. One in the books here, Richard. Kylie, that was an amazing round.
Yeah, good round.
So, Richard, if you had to take a look at some of that action, how would you score it? Obviously, there were some good takedowns for Politywo, some good activity from Kelly off his back. Let's take a look at some of the highlights.
Yeah, by virtue of the fact that Pawel got more takedowns and he also dropped Nate with a big overhand right, I think it was, I would give that round to him. But Nathan, very, very effective off his back, was doing serious damage, and that will accumulate, and Pawel will feel that in the later rounds. Oh, great shot.
Yeah, there was that big overhand right.
Yeah.
And the level change in the commitment from Politywo, you know, taking your man down, bringing him all the way to the edge of the ring, charging through, getting the pickup. That's great wrestling for MMA.
Absolutely, yeah. You can see him, he covered the distance very, very quickly. And as soon as he got hold of Nathan, it was only one way he was going. He lifted him up and slammed him down.
So, seconds out. Round two of a scheduled three here on tap tonight in Dublin. So two of a scheduled three here between that man, Nathan Kelly, taken down, dropped in the first round, but never out of the fight. On the other side, of course, the Polish fighter turned Dublin native, Pawel Politylo in the red corner. The question in my mind is, Richard, does Politylo go back to that takedown? Does he look for the overhand right, or does he mix things up?
I think he should mix things up. As I said, Nathan is a very fluid fighter, and you can see that. You can see that in how he conducts himself in his comfort, both on the feet and on the cage. The one concern I would have with Pawel is you see that lean muscle mass. He's very, very bulky, that he might be able to sustain that pace throughout the entire round.
And if you're in the corner of Nathan Kelly, do you want more jabs? Do you want more volume with the boxing to try to defend against that takedown? Lots of straight punches.
I'm a huge advocate of the jab. The jab is probably one of your most important punches. You know, as he's coming in, he should be eating that jab. See, that jab should be right in his face. But so if I was Nathan Kelly, that left hand is low again. He doesn't want to get caught with that overhand right.
And Kelly looking to set those kicks up. Oh, nice straight punch. Pawel Politywo looking to catch that pass. Throwing the legs to the side and load up on those downward strikes.
Just as I said that, his left hand is low. He doesn't want to get caught with the overhand right. Pawel must have heard me because he caught him right on the right hand. I should be getting paid extra for coaching Pawel here.
And what an amazing turn of events here in Dublin. Politywo looking to try to close the show, but great defense here from Kelly.
Great composure. You know, that's the second time he's after showing great composure. It shows him a maturity beyond his years to be able to keep his head clear and be able to do the right thing after getting rocked like that. The easiest thing to do is panic, and he's after getting a stand up. Excellent stuff by Nathan.
And Declan Larkin making the right decision there. Yep. You know, you're looking for a fighter to improve and work on those positions, those hard fought positions such as that where you do put a fighter down.
Absolutely. I would hope that I want Nathan here to just raise that hand. He's after keeps getting caught with that overhand right. Pawel again is looking for it. Good single leg defense here by Nathan.
Head inside single. Politywo looking to convert.
Excellent.
Great defense here from Nathan Kelly. Kelly working in that scramble and effectively defending the single leg.
Absolutely, particularly against guys as powerful as Pawel. You can see the muscle mass in him there, you know, and to be able to defend that single leg and do it with such composure, you know, it's a testament to Nathan Kelly's ability. I'd just like to see him a little bit busier with this jab here now, just to make Pawel hesitant about coming in and throwing that overhand right. See that left hand is dropping again.
Politylo starting to look a little bit tired here. Kelly surging, 2-3 for Kelly. Crowd noticeably at fever pitch here tonight in the 3 Arena as the young man, the 20-year-old Nathan Kelly, looks to try to pour on the pressure against Pawel Politylo.
Absolutely, Pawel, you can see those arms getting heavy, and when Sweeper starts bound on the feet and shaking out those arms, that's an indicator that the lactic acid is building up. If I were him, I would stay away from the kicks. They're high-energy techniques, but they're not having much effect.
Shot here from Politylo. Can he get the takedown? He's got those hands clasped, Richard.
Yeah, I think that was more out of tiredness than it was out of looking to get the takedown. It wasn't as effective or as explosive as it was in the first. So Nathan Kelly could be in the ascendancy here now. If he puts the pace on Pawel, it'd be interesting to see how this fight turns around.
Couple of knees on the inside for Pawel Politylo. And I love seeing guys who on paper don't have a ton of pro experience, but they have that well-coached base. Both fighters showing skill in all positions. Good punches, good kicks, good clinch work.
Nice.
There's everything for everyone to watch, you know, in a young MMA fighter in this matchup.
Absolutely. Look, I wouldn't base, you know, based on these guys' records, you wouldn't assume they have the skill that they have. But even in the exchanges, that in between phase on breakoffs, they're catching strikes.
Well, tonight we've had something for everyone in this fight. Chris Hoekstra on the call alongside the face of Bama, turn voice of Bama. Absolutely. Richard, Kylie, great to be with you folks on the prelims. And another key moment here for Nathan Kelly.
Great takedown. Again, nice and composed, waiting for his moment, felt the shift and the balance lifting him and slammed him.
And you really feel that was the right time to initiate that takedown with that control that he had.
It is. He has another round to go, and all this he's making Pawel carry in his entire weight. So that's gonna sap that energy of Pawel. You know, and I would imagine that Nathan is looking at the third round now to really capitalize and put Pawel away.
Half guard here. It's open for the pass. Now, Politylo looking to close up. Deep half is a funky thing in MMA, though, Richard.
Absolutely. Look at Nathan here now. He's just putting the pressure. He's making this a grind. He's putting the elbows in Pavel's face, making him carry his weight, the shoulder into the throat and the jaw. It's very uncomfortable as he looks to pass.
He's looking for that knee slice here. And that deep head pressure, the far side underhook, all that's really helping him here to try to improve.
Absolutely. That's deeply unpleasant. We know it's not going to end a fight, but it's very, very unpleasant in the middle of it, an exchange.
So there you have it, Nathan Kelly on top to end the second round. The big question is, Richard, Kiley, is it 1-1 at this point? Was that enough to take that 10-9?
I don't know, to be honest. It's very, very close here. It's very...
And here, those big exchanges, you know, we did see some significant work from Politylo, dipping the head, looking for that overhand right. He did catch Nathan Kelly a couple times, but the cardio seemed to shift. You talked about high-energy techniques. Nathan Kelly able to take advantage by the end of the round. Here's how he did it.
Absolutely. That overhand right is scoring time and time again for Pawel. The only thing now is, I don't know if he's out there expending his energy, so hopefully he's able to recuperate in this round. If I was Nathan Kelly's coach, I'd be telling him to really pile the pressure on him. Really pile the pressure on now. Make this a high-energy fight and break Pavel's will. It'd be very interesting to see what happens now in the third and final round.
So difficult to say how that last round was scored, but it's a fresh start on the feet. Round three. Third and final. So the third and final frame here in Dublin at the 3 Arena between two young, hungry competitors. Nathan Kelly, Pawel Politylo. Kelly working that clinch, catching that takedown at the end of the second. Richard, you talked about it during the break. You want to see lots of energy. You want to see him really go in there and try to win this round convincingly.
Yeah, this is when Pavel's going to be at his most dangerous. He's got to recuperate slightly, so he'll be looking for that big overhand right. Nate needs to raise that guard. He's going to get caught. See the way Pawel keeps winging that in? He's going to keep looking for that now. So Nate needs to just be cautious, pile on the pressure, and really hurt him with those jabs.
You see that lead hand there. Kelly looking for the jab.
There you go.
Nice head movement from Pawel. He looks to have regained some of that oxygen debt, but the thing is, Richard, how long does that last? 5 minutes is a long time.
Absolutely. Well, right now, Nathan's playing into his hands. No, he's giving him an easy time. He needs to, like I said, he needs to pile on the pressure here. This, as I said, Pavel will lift him up, slam it, and he'll just try and hold him here now. He'll try and regain his energy.
And, of course, win the round. I think they'll be very confident of winning that first. The second was closer.
Yep.
If you're in Pavel's corner, it might be a smart thing to try to ride this third and final one out.
Absolutely. You know, if I was the judges looking at this now, see Pavel on the ascendancy after getting the takedown here, and, you know, he's piling the pressure on Nathan and being aggressive. Nathan really needs to stand up here now and start working Pavel and recoup the points here in this round.
So looking for that figure four is Nathan Kelly. Tough to catch, but he's regained guard. Very nice. Open guard. Nice. Butterfly hooks are in here for Nathan Kelly. On top is Pawel Politylo, trying to fight, trying to pass. A real jockey for position here right now, Richard.
Yeah, yeah. When Nathan's after doing excellent there to reverse it now. He's up to get the waist lock now and down. He's going to look to ground and pound and do the exact same as he did in the towards the end of the second round. Make this ugly and really pound Pawel out.
Well, it's been an eventful night here at the 3 Arena. Great to have you folks tuned in on Unilab Worldwide, the BAMMA 35 prelims. Streaming exclusively on Facebook from the 3 Arena, Chris Hoekstra. Alongside me, our guest commentator, former world title challenger, Richard Kiley.
Soon to be world champion, Chris.
Well, we've had a real tussle here so far between Nathan Kelly. The third round here on tap. Taking on Pawel Politylo. Kelly on his back. That's been kind of the story of the fight so far. 2.5 minutes left in this round. Kelly doing everything he can to try to catch that sweep or stand up.
Yeah. Again, he's utilizing the elbows, but he's not as effectively now. He's just kind of winging them now. He needs to really pick those shots. If I were him, I'd be looking to stand up and or reverse Pawel and really take control of this. Those elbows off the ground, unless he gets a really bad cut, they're not going to win him the fight.
And that was great decision-making there to not catch Pawel while he was grounded with that up kick. But you talked about it in the first round. When you're on your back, you've got to use those positions to try to frustrate your opponent. He did so, he stood up, now he's on top.
He is, but I really want to see him being aggressive here now, and being aggressive in guard. You know, either working for a submission or really, really pound grab up Pawel out.
Tons of pressure here from Nathan Kelly. He's got that pass if he wants it. Can he get a dominant position? 1 minute and 40 seconds to go in Dublin.
Into mount.
Full mount here for Nathan Kelly.
He is in full mount now. It'll be interesting to see what he can do here. Really, now, Pawel, if Pavel's energy levels are low, Nathan's really going to go for this. And is he going for the rear naked choke? He is.
He's got both hooks in right now. He's going to fish to try to get underneath that chin.
Pawel looks tired here. Pawel looks tired here. He really needs to dig down deep, not give in.
And the determination of the 20-year-old Nathan Kelly, with the crowd behind him tonight at the 3 Arena in search of that first big professional win. Absolutely. Has just been inspirational to see.
Absolutely. Both guys here are putting on an absolutely spectacular performance. Nathan Kelly, as I said, no professional experience before, and you can see his level of skill. I just think that extra bit of experience that Pawel has is really serving him well here in this fight.
That being said, though, Kelly gets that body triangle.
He is. He could prove me a lawyer here. He's not under the chin. He's looking to soften Pawel up with those strikes.
The dying moments of the third round here. Nathan Kelly trying to submit Pawel Politylo.
He really needs to go for it now. 30 seconds left. He needs to pile the pressure on here. Open him up with strikes to see if he can slip that hand under the chin and lock that rear naked choke in.
So great to have with you folks watching on Unilad here from the 3 Arena. BAMMA 35, the prelims, streaming live and exclusively on Facebook. What an amazing night. So many fine, young, hungry, talented Irish fighters. Nathan Kelly taking on Pawel Politylo, an amazing matchup here.
Excellent fight, really, really technical, really, really technical, and you know, there's a bit of everything in this fight. And Pawel is in survival mode at the moment, but it's a testament that he's after putting this out. Well done to both fighters.
What an amazing fight, and the crowd, a standing ovation in the bleachers for both men as they embrace 15 minutes of back-and-forth battle. And Richard Kiley, it was all about that takedown.
It was all about the takedown. Pawel had two big moments in with the two big overhand rights, but in this fight, he went straight for the takedown. I would have expected Nathan to expect that, but Pawel got a hold of it. But Nathan did very, very well to be able to reverse these as well. You see that takedown by Pawel. And here's Nathan said, Nathan has it in the waist lock and takes him down and puts the pressure on. Very, very interesting round, a difficult round to score for again for the juniors.
And really, it was a case where Pawel was able to take him down a couple of times, and then Nathan was able to get back up once Pawel got tired and do the same to him.
Exactly. When Nathan was more dominant, he got the more dominant position. He nearly had it locked in the rear naked choke. Both guys seem to think they've won it. So it's very, very tough round to call. I'm glad I'm not a judge.
So both men await the decision here tonight at the Premier Arena. Both bright young talents, undoubtedly a promising future for each individual, but there can only be one. And as the numbers come in, great to be with you folks once again on Unilad, streaming worldwide for the prelims here for the next 2 hours on the road to the main card. So many barn burner matchups on tap tonight. So for Chris Hoekstra, alongside Richard Kiley, our guest commentator here tonight. Kiley, former world title challenger here. You fought here at the 3 Arena. You're excited for tonight's card.
I did. Come here to Alex Lahore versus Pascu. Two great fighters. Myself and Alex have history. So, you know, I put that aside. And I'll be interested. So I can't wait to see this fight. Excellent card on hand for everyone, the viewers viewing tonight.
And here's the verdict from Buddy Johnson.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout goes a distance, 3 rounds, and we go to your judges' scorecards. Judge Ben Cartledge scores the bout 29-28 in favor of the red corner. Judge Kevin Carpel scores the bout 29-28 in favor of the blue corner. And our third and final judge scores the bout, Mr. Mark Collette, scores the bout 29-28, declaring your winner by split decision. In the red corner, Pawel Politylo.
Well, Pawel Politylo has done it. 29-28, a split decision, but the decision that gets him that W. 2-1 now in the professional ranks. And a very active 2017. 4 fights in 2017, 1 to the good so far in 2018. Richard, a great performance, both guys, but Pawel gets that next step in his BAMMA career tonight.